This week saw record profits for a leisure company founded 5 years ago by a man who was then 73. He's a peer with an empire from Blackpool to the West End, a player in one of the century's best rags-to-riches stories, and at 78 he ought to have a well-thumbed pension book, although I suspect not. Lord Delfont, you've stepped down as chairman of First Leisure. Does that mean you've thrown in the towel?
Oh, absolutely not. I couldn't think of retiring. I think I'll be, sort of, as I've always said, I think I'll be in God's waiting room. I just will never retire.
Let's talk a little bit about First Leisure. It seems to concentrate on fairly conservative family entertainment values, yeah. Seaside amusements, discos, plays like Alo Alo, yeah. South Pacific Last Night. Do you think there's a continuing market for that sort of thing?
Absolutely. I mean, the leisure public are very, very wide. There'll be more leisure spending and more leisure time in the future. And, of course, our particular company, we believe in catering for the mass public, the ordinary man in the street and the woman in the street, and we give them the best value in excellent circumstances. And I'm not looking to run a sort of high-class establishments, although all our establishments are, of course, first-class, and I'd be very proud if they were in Mayfair or anything like that. But we do give value and pleasure, and giving pleasure to the public, gives me pleasure, and that's why I love the business I'm in. That's why I have no intention of retiring, but obviously I have to take care of the company. And the new man we've got, Michael Cotterill, I'm sure is going to be even more successful than we've been, fortunately, so up to now.
You've been a businessman for over 50 years. What sort of advice would you give to somebody who was starting a business now?
Well, I think it's very difficult to give advice to anybody, but I think you have to have faith in yourself. And take your time, because I was in difficulties, although I had some sort of reputation. I was in difficulties even when I was 45. So, I mean, you know, you can't make it straight away. You have to persevere. And also, I've never really had the sort of a goal and ambition to get to. It's just happened naturally, and I've been fortunate too.
Very briefly, your recipe for longevity?
Oh, well, I've always said the same thing. No fresh air, that's very bad for you. And, of course, no exercise, and a few whiskies, and lots of cigars.
You look very good in it. Lord Delfont, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.